Hello everybody, this is Claudio Quavivi speaking again. In our last video, we implement a basic access control policy based on Okta's groups and claims. OpenID Konnect claims, according to the official specification, are a piece of information asserted about an entity. Name, family name, picture, etc. are claim examples for users. On the other hand, OpenID Konnect scopes are a group of claims. So for this fourth video, you're going to define a new claim based on an Okta group. The claim will be included in all scopes defined. On the other hand, the Konnect OIDC plugin to allow the con route consumption will check if the coming tokens have this specific claim included. Only users who are part of the Okta group will have the claim included in the token, and therefore we'll be able to consume the route. So let's check our Okta configuration now. First of all, I have created two users and one group. Here are my users, and here's the con group. And as you can see, the group has only one member. Again, the new claim will be based on this group, so only its members will have permission to consume the conk route. And here's the new conk claim definition. It is based on the conk group and is going to be included in any scope for each access token issued. So now let's run a token preview to check the tokens and the claim out. For the first request, I'm going to use the user who is not a con group member. The Okta application is the same authorization code we used before. Grant type is authorization code, and we're going to use the standard OpenID scope. As expected, the access token doesn't have any conk claim inside of it. However, if you use the other user, since he belongs to the conk group, the access token will be different. Here's the conk claim inside our token. Now let's check our conk route with the OIDC plugin enabled. So here's the service, the version, the route, and the plugin. As you can see, the new parameters are saying that the plugin should check if the token has the conk claim we defined in Okta. So in this sense, the route should be consumed only by users who are members of the conk group. Now you're ready to consume the route using both users. Similar to what we've done in Okta's token preview process, for the first request, I'm going to use the user who is not included in the conk group. As expected, we shouldn't be able to consume the route. We'll try to consume the route, but since we don't have any token injected inside our request, the API gateway is redirecting us to Okta so we can present our credentials. And after getting authenticated, Okta is redirecting us back to the API gateway. However, since the token doesn't have the claim inside of it, the gateway won't allow us to consume the route. And now let's use the other user who is member of the conk group. Again, we try to consume the route, getting redirected to Okta, but this time we're going to use the second user. Again, after getting authenticated, Okta is going to redirect us back to API Gateway. However, this time our token has got the con claim we defined in Okta previously. As a matter of fact, if we go to jwt.io website, we'll be able to decode the JWT token and check the token and the claim inside of it. That concludes the last video of our series. I hope you have liked it again. Thank you so much.